Welcome to chapter wise past paper analysis. You will get here the previous year's CBSE question papers of class 10 social science. We will do it in chapter wise to make it easy and systematic. Students must practice these questions to revise the huge syllabus of social science and prepare effectively for the board examination. CBSE Class 10 Social Science examination is of 3 hours duration and for a maximum 80 marks. Full chapter CBSE guide is ready to help you with chapter wise past paper analysis. Now we are going to look at frequently asked 3 mark questions or short answer questions from history chapter 1. Question number 1. Explain any 3 beliefs of the conservatism that emerged after 1815. Answer is, conservatism that emerged after 1815 believed that established and traditional institutions of state and society like monarchy, the church, property and family should be preserved. They believed in the modernization of the traditional institution to strengthen them rather than returning to the society of pre-revolutionary days. Also, they believed that abolition of feudalism and serfdom and replacing it with a modern army, an efficient bureaucracy and a dynamic economy could strengthen autocratic monarchies of Europe. Next question. Explain the contribution of Otto von Bismarck in German unification. Nationalist feelings started spreading among the middle-class Germans who in 1848 tried to unite different parts of German Confederation into a nation state to have an elected parliamentarian government. However, this liberal movement was repressed by the combined forces of monarchy and military supported by Prussian landowners. Prussian Chief Minister Otto von Bismarck took the responsibility of national unification with the help of Prussian army and bureaucracy. Under his leadership, he fought 3 wars over 7 years with Austria, Denmark and France. Prussia was victorious in all these wars and the process of unification of Germany was completed as a result of Prussia's victory over France. Next question. Explain any 3 ways in which nationalist feelings were kept alive in Poland in the 18th and 19th centuries. The 3 ways in which nationalist feelings were kept alive in 18th and 19th centuries in Poland were emphasis on vernacular language. Language played an important role in developing nationalist sentiments. The use of the Polish language came to be seen as a symbol of struggle against Russian dominance. For example, in Poland, following armed rebellion against Russian rule, Polish was used for church gatherings and religious instruction. As a result, a number of priests and bishops were put in jails or sent to Siberia as punishment for their refusal to preach in Russian. Second point is emphasis on collection of local folklore. It was not just to recover an ancient national spirit, but also to carry the modern nationalist message to the large audience who were mostly illiterate. Use of music to keep the nationalist feelings alive. For example, Karol Kurpinski celebrated the national struggle through his operas and music, turning folk dances like the Polonaise and Mazurka into nationalist symbols. Next question. Explain the contribution of Giuseppe Mazzini in spreading revolutionary ideas in Europe. The year following 1815 was the period of revolutionaries. Most of the revolutionaries were committed to oppose monarchical forms and to fight for liberty and freedom. One such prominent revolutionary was Giuseppe Mazzini, an Italian revolutionary. Mazzini also saw the creation of nation states as a necessary part in the struggle for freedom. He strongly believed in the unification of Italy as a single unified republic, which would be the basis of Italian liberty. Mazzini's relentless opposition to monarchy and his vision of a democratic republic frightened the conservatives. His ideas also influenced the revolutionaries of Germany, France, Switzerland, and Poland. Next question. Describe any three reforms introduced by Napoleon in the territories he conquered. Three reforms introduced by Napoleon in the territories he conquered were: the Napoleonic Code. It removed all the privileges based on birth and established equality before law and secured the right to property. He simplified administrative divisions, abolished the feudal system, and freed peasants from serfdom and manorial dues. He introduced uniform laws, standardized weights and measures, and common national currency to facilitate the movement and exchange of goods and capital from one place to another. Next question. Explain any three causes of conflict in the Balkan area after 1871. The nationalist tensions emerged in the Balkans due to the following reasons. Balkans was a region of geographical and ethnic variation comprising modern-day Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, Greece, Macedonia, Croatia, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Slovenia, Serbia, and Montenegro, whose inhabitants were known as the Slavs. A large part of Balkans was under the control of the Ottoman Empire. After the decline of the Ottoman Empire and the growth of Romantic nationalism in the Balkans, the region became very explosive. Its European subject nationalities broke away from its control and declared independence. As the different nationalities struggled to define their identity and independence, the Balkan area became an area of intense conflict. The Balkan states were fiercely jealous of each other, and each hoped to gain more territory at the expense of others. Balkan also became the scene of big power rivalry. Russia, Germany, England, Austria, Hungary, all big powers were keen in countering the hold of other powers. This ultimately turned Balkan into a war region, which eventually provided a minor cause for the First World War. Next question. How did the local people in the areas conquered by Napoleon react to French rule? The reactions of the local population to the French rule were mixed. Initially, in many places such as Holland and Switzerland, as well as in cities like Brussels, Mainz, Milan, and Warsaw, the French armies were welcomed as carriers of liberty. As new administrative arrangements did not go hand in hand with political freedom, enthusiasm turned into hostility. Increased taxation, censorship, forced conscription into the French armies to conquer the rest of Europe outweighed the advantages of the administrative changes. Next question. Explain the conditions that were viewed as obstacles to the economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes during the 19th century in Europe. In the economic sphere, liberalism stood for the freedom of markets and the abolition of state-imposed restrictions on movement of goods and capital. But in the 19th century, Napoleon's administrative measures had created out of countless small principalities a confederation of 39 states. Each possessed its own currency and weights and measures. A merchant traveling from Hamburg to Nuremberg had to pass through 11 custom barriers and pay 5% duty at each one of them. As each region had its own system of weights and measures, this involved time-consuming calculations. such conditions were viewed as obstacles to economic growth and exchange by the new commercial classes who argued for the creation of a unified economic territory allowing free movement of goods, people and capital. Next question. Describe the events of French Revolution which had influenced the people belonging to other parts of Europe, or describe any three steps taken by the French revolutionaries to create a sense of collective identity among the French people. The first clear-cut expression of nationalism came with the French Revolution in 1789. In 1789, France was under the rule of an absolute monarch. When the revolutionaries came to power in France, they were determined to create a new sense of unity and nationhood. For this, they emphasized the concept of France being the fatherland, la patrie, for all French people who were from now on addressed as citizens, that is, citoyen. They were given the tricolor flag, the three colors representing liberty, equality, and fraternity. French revolutionaries introduced various other measures, such as the Estate General was elected by the body of active citizens and renamed the National Assembly. New hymns were composed, oaths were taken, and martyrs were commemorated, all in the name of the nation. A centralized administrative system was put in place, and it formulated uniform laws for all citizens within its territory. Internal customs duties and dues were abolished, and a uniform system of weights and measures was adopted. Regional dialects were discouraged, and French, as it was spoken and written in Paris, became the common language of the nation. They further declared that it was the mission and destiny of the French nation to liberate the people of Europe from despotism and help them to become nations. Next question. How did nationalism develop through culture in Europe? Explain or describe the role of culture in shaping the feelings of nationalism in Europe from 1830 to the end of 19th century. Culture, music, dance and religion played an important role in the growth of nationalism. Culture. Role of culture was important in creating the idea of the nation. Art, poetry, music, etc. helped in developing and expressing nationalist feelings. Romanticism was a cultural movement that led to the development of nationalist sentiment. Romantic artists and poets criticized the glorification of reason and science and instead focused on emotions and intuition. Language. Language too played an important role in developing nationalist sentiments. After Russian occupation, the Polish language was forced out of schools and Russian language was imposed everywhere. In 1831, an armed rebellion against Russian rule took place, which was ultimately crushed. Following this, many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Music and dance. Romantics such as the German philosopher Herder claimed that true German culture was to be discovered among the common people. It was through folk songs, folk poetry and folk dances that the true spirit of the nation was popularized. Next question. How had the female figures become an allegory of the nation during 19th century in Europe? Analyze. Artists in the 18th and 19th centuries portrayed nations as female figures. The female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life. Rather, it sought to give the abstract idea of the nation in concrete form. That is, the female figure became the allegory of the nation. In France, she was named Marianne, a popular Christian name, and in Germany, Germania. Germania wears a crown of oak leaves, as the German oak stands for heroism. The characteristics of Marianne were drawn from those ideas of liberty and republic. The symbols like the red cap, the tricolor and cockade used to represent liberty and republic. Next question. Describe any three economic hardships faced by Europe in the 1830s. Europe had come under the grip of large-scale unemployment. In most of the countries, there were more seekers of jobs than employment. Cities had become overcrowded and slums had emerged as population from the rural areas migrated to the cities. Small producers in towns were often faced with stiff competition from imports of cheap machine-made goods from England, where industrialization was more advanced, especially in the field of textile production. In those regions of Europe where aristocracy still enjoyed power, peasants struggled under the burden of feudal dues and obligations. The rise of food prices and barn harvest added to the hardships of the peasants. We hope the given 3-mark questions for History Chapter 1 with answers will help you. If you have any query regarding this, please drop a comment below and we will get back to you at the earliest. Thank you. Thank you for watching.